children see him, mom and I.
Oh. Jesus, come and worship him. He's my master, savior. Come and worship him.
Come and worship him.
King of kings, Lord of lords.
Good evening. I will be reading the word from Luke, second chapter, verses 1 through 20, from the New Revised Standard Version, the birth of Jesus. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger because there was no place for them in the inn, the shepherds and the angels. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly, there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." Now, when the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told to them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told to them. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
Thank you. It's beautiful. Thank you. Will you say a word of prayer with me, please? Eternal God, your word is a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our path. And as we just briefly reflect tonight on incarnation, may the words of my mouth and the meditations of all of our hearts be acceptable in your sight, O God, our rock and our redeemer. This is a weird Christmas. It's hot outside. It's hot in here. It's hot in here. This is a strange year. I don't know about you, but I come to this Christmas different than any other time. Great grief over the mad, crazy violence and vitriol in our culture. Heartbroken for the countless, countless black and brown bodies laying in the ground, the countless ways that a few people have hijacked the lives of others with their hatred, killing folks in churches, killing folks in school. I mean, Lord have mercy. And when I come to Christmas like this, I'm looking for, I don't know, answers to questions I didn't used to ask. Is anybody with me? Yeah. Like where is God right there when Beirut happens and when Paris happens? And how do we come to understand people saying in the name of God that they're just going to wreak havoc on one another? What? A hot mess, right? A hot mess. I come to Christmas this year with different kinds of questions than I've ever had before. And I'm looking for answers that I don't think I thought I'd find them. But I am seeing in the midst of the violence and in the midst of the vitriol, in the midst of the crazy and in the midst of the cacophony, I'm seeing good people of every faith standing up for one another. I'm seeing signs of something new erupting in the wilderness. I'm seeing signs of hope that look to me like, I don't know, maybe there's some kind of new religiosity developing. Now, it's Christmas, and I know that means we're supposed to be talking about candlelight and carols and Christmas trees. Amen? But I feel like I need to talk for just a second about the child, because after all, this thing is about the child. This thing is about a multiracial, multicultural, multiethnic
child who was born in Palestine to Jewish parents, and his ancestors were African, Asian, European, and Jewish. He's like, okay, maybe even like a mixed up nut, okay? Oh, God, forgive me for saying that. But God chose to come, my faith says, all the way down to earth in that mixed up baby. In that body, that particular body, that mixed up body, God came all the way down to live amongst us, to be one of us, and to, in his blood, literally be just like us. How many of you call yourself Christians that are in the room? Okay, so put your hands down. Everybody else, this is for you. Shh, hang on. I'm coming. You don't have to be Christian to believe what I'm about to tell you. God came all the way down in little bitty baby flesh. Or love came down in little bitty baby flesh. Love came down. Love came pouring out of Mary's body. Love was born. Love was born in Bethlehem. And love was born in a vulnerable baby who needed to be loved in order to survive. Like, that's just a magical story to me. Not a king, not a prince, not a herald, but a baby, a little baby who needed to have his nappy changed, needed to be burped, probably threw up a little bit, you know, a little stanky stank after meals, you know what I'm saying. A real baby, a real little baby, our story says, came all the way to be loved, and to teach love. So you don't have to be a Christian to believe that. You don't have to be a Christian to believe that love can cause love. That love inspires love, that love provokes love, that love demands love. Amen? Amen? And what's happening right now is there's so much junk, the only response is love. So this morning, on Christmas Eve, which happens to be the Prophet Muhammad's birthday, peace be upon him, this morning, a love letter that had been written to Muslims by a whole bunch of religious leaders of every faith, that 23,973 folks had signed. 23,973. Can you just picture that? That many people signed the letter. And we took it to this Muslim community. And there was a little Muslim boy who told us that where he finds his hope is in the love of his little sister. And the little Muslim sister said she finds her hope in the kindness of strangers. This real Muslim community, I'm not talking about those people who are killing people, because they're not Muslim people. They're just killers. Somebody say amen. Amen. I mean, this real community of Muslim people got a love letter and were deeply moved by it because love came down to inspire us to stand with them, stand for them, be with them, be amongst them. Love causes us to do radically welcoming, loving things. So that's what this is about. This story is about that. This story is about incarnation, meaning love puts on flesh and bones. Love dresses up in sinew and tendon and muscle. Love then gets busy loving the world and causing love to happen like a wave, like a cascading wave. And love is stronger than hate. Say with me, love is stronger than hate. Love is stronger than hate. Multiracial, multicultural, multi-ethnic little Jewish boy, Jesus was not a Christian. We hadn't invented that yet. I'm one. But Jesus was not. He was a Jewish rabbi who caused a love revolution. I'm not going to show the movie that we have queued up to show you because you want to hear the music more than you want to see film. But I want to tell you. What I love about my team is we're nimble, you know? Let's not do that. You look like love to me. I love you back. The scriptures say we are the body of Christ. And again, I'm talking to the non-Christians, meaning we are the body of the Messiah. Meaning, are you ready? We are the body of the anointed. You are anointed. You are anointed. If you're an atheist, you're anointed to love. If you're an agnostic, you're anointed to love. If you're a Jewish person, one of my friends, I'm going to wink at her, tells me she's a Jewish Christian feminist, right? I mean, you are anointed to love. You Christians are anointed to love, and you're anointed to love expansively, Christians. Now I'm talking to you like Jesus loved, crossing every border, every boundary to make love everywhere. That's what the incarnation is. So, yeah, Christmas trees, carols, candles, or the child. The child who came out of love for love to teach us how to love ridiculously. And to not imagine that God doesn't love all of them. Because God loves all of them and God loves all of you. It's the incarnation when you do love. Amen. Now, we do love here in lots of different ways. We feed people, I'll show you the movie another time. We do love lots of ways. We feed people, we do music, we activate for Black Lives Matter, we do the interreligious thing. If you'd like to be a part of a group of people who, when the Japanese people throwing down the gospel, come on now, that's a really, that's a really special church, right? I love that. So this is who we are, and if you'd like to be a part of it, we'd love to have you. Just fill out the green card in the pew in front of you, and the guy who let the thing back up will give you a personal phone call. No, then we'll call you, we'll check in on you, and we'd love to have you join us. And if you feel like you can make an offering, we'd love to have that too. It makes the music happen. It makes the justice flow. And the choir's gonna come back in and the band's gonna do their thing and the ushers are gonna pass bags and, you know, make magic happen. Make love everywhere. Thank you.
Just one look, one look at Jesus, and my cares will all pass away. Only one look was all I needed. Forever.
So this is the Middle Church Jerese Johnson Gospel Choir. And Jerese started this choir 30 years ago. 30 years ago. Jerese, when we take Jerese's name around, nobody can say his name. So we struggle. And Middle Church, too, because they're like, Middle Church, what's that? I'm not sure. Collegiate, huh? But Jerese was such a special individual. And tonight, in the choir, we have someone who started the choir with Jerese. What? Yes, you need to be amazed, because it's Janine Borkrevink. She came down from California. Oh, she's a mess. She's a mess. But that's okay. But this choir has history in this community and in this church. And it's been moving and shaking for 30 years. You don't know the seeds that you're planting. When you put money in the offering plate, you don't know where that's going to go. And that's why you just need to put it with a glad heart. Because Jerese did it with an exuberant heart when they asked the 20 members of the church, what would you like to do to maybe get the ministry going a little, right? And he said, how about a gospel choir? How about a gospel choir? And it didn't start like this, right? But that was the seed. We're responsible for the seed sometimes. Sometimes you don't get here, but you get to the seed. So you have to be faithful with that. Be faithful. Be faithful. And Carter, her son, is here as well. Carter, give a hand up. Woo! Yes, sir, buddy. Let's have Tina Squared come on up. Yes.
Let's sing.
Sing some
He made a way. What these are for. Well, now is the time to take it out. If you don't have a glow stick, please raise your hand and our ushers will try to get one to you. We have one up front, a couple on the center aisle, one in the back. And gospel choir, you're getting yours now. So let us all take a deep breath. Feel God's presence with us as we wait for some glow sticks to get handed out. I will let you know when to crack it, so please don't yet. I think some of you already got us started, and let us say a word of prayer together before we dim the lights. Holy God, as the story goes, you came at night when all was still. Enter our lives this night. Illumine our paths with the light of Christ's presence, that we may clearly see the way before us, the truth to speak, and the life you lead us on. Let us join together with one another now as the body of Christ to live out your call on our lives as we work together for change, for a better future for all people, and as we shine light on the darkness in our world. Amen. And now Christina will dim the lights for us, and we will all crack our glow sticks together. Woo. They're a little challenging. Yes. Crack it, shake it, and sing with me, Silent Night.
Oh,
wait a minute. Hey, look at your stick. Look at your glow thing. This light, scripture says, represents the light that is the light of every human being, and the darkness cannot overcome it. Violence can't overcome it. Hatred can't overcome it. Massacres can't overcome it. Now, yeah, okay. Except that one couple in Paris, one was a Muslim and one was a Jew, and the spouse died, and instead of shutting it down, he kept the doors open for interreligious cooperation. Hello? Yeah. Except 23,000 people signed a love letter for Muslims and delivered it on Christmas Day. And we will not have our hopes dashed. We will not reduce each other to tweetable sound bites of bias and prejudice. We will not be overcome by fear, because we will love. Somebody say amen. This is our call. Doesn't matter how you name God. Doesn't matter what your creed is. Doesn't matter how you profess God. Doesn't matter if you don't profess God at all. We don't care. Middle loves atheists. Just bring your love power. Just bring your hope. Go into the night with your light and make love where? Everywhere.